Hello, my name is John Nelson, Business Manager with Haas Automation. We've produced this video to introduce you to the new DXF Import feature now available in the Haas Control. The ability to import a CAD drawing directly in the machine's control and use an integrated programming system is becoming more and more valuable to customers around the globe. Whether it's a small shop with no offline programming capability, or a large factory where CNC resources are tied up on large projects, the ability to apply toolpaths directly to CAD data in the machine is becoming useful for many machinists. Users have had the ability to create toolpaths in the Haas Control for many years now. The DXF Import feature is just an extension of that programming capability. The DXF Import feature will be included with the intuitive programming system, so it'll be standard on all toolroom products and optional on all other Haas machines. To get started, a little prep work is required. As with any programming system, you'll need to define your tools and tool data. In the setup section of the intuitive programming system, you'll need to define your work offsets and your workpiece material. You'll also need to enter the necessary data for all the tools in your program. If you have a turret or a carousel full of tools, you can set up a tool library and save that information out with your offsets. If changes are required at a later time, you can always go back and alter the data. You'll need to have a clean DXF file, so strip out any unnecessary geometry and keep just what's required to program your part. This will make navigation easier and speed up your programming process. With all the information in the Setup tab complete, let's import a DXF. Just like loading any other program into the machine's memory, use the List Prog key to navigate to your DXF file. Press F2 to copy, be sure memory is highlighted, and use the right Enter key. Your DXF will appear on the screen. The programming process consists of three simple steps. The first step is to set the origin. When the DXF file comes into the Haas Control, the origin is set from the original drawing. We use the black circular crosshair position indicator to represent the cursor in the DXF file. We also use the red datum symbol to indicate the position of the origin. You always want to change your origin to the position where you will set your work offset, you know, G54, G55. You have two easy options to change the location of the origin. The first option is to jog the position indicator with the hand jog wheel or the jog keys. The second option is to use the up-down arrows, which will scroll through the entities in the drawing. When you use this method, the crosshair location snaps to the start point of each selected entity. I'm going to use the up-down arrows to reset my origin to the lower right corner of my drawing. When the crosshair is in the correct location for your work offset, press the right Enter key to set the origin. The box below the drawing has changed to show you the steps to follow, and you'll notice step 1, origin, is now green, indicating that step is complete. This brings us to step 2 of the programming process, creating a chain of the drawing entities to define the toolpath. Use the hand jog wheel or the up-down arrows to scroll through the entities in the drawing. Scroll until the correct starting entity of your desired chain turns red and the arrowhead is pointing in the proper cut direction. Press the F2 key to bring up the Chain Options dialog box, highlight Automatic Chaining, and press the right Enter key. You'll notice all the entities in the chain have changed color. Notice under the Current Groups heading, we now have Group 1 defined, and there is a colored box next to Group 1 indicating the color of all the entities in that group. In the step box below the drawing, Step 2, Chain, has changed to green, indicating that step is complete. Now we arrive at the third and final step of our programming process, defining a cutting operation. I press F3 to apply a cutting operation to the chained entities. You will see the toolpath operation pop-up box appear on the screen. Highlight the desired toolpath type and press the right Enter key. Follow the on-screen instructions as the next steps vary depending on the cut type selected. I'm going to choose a face tool operation and press the right Enter key. This will bring up the Intuitive Programming System tab for the face tool operation. Enter the cut data in the boxes and press the F4 key to record the G-code output to a program. The IPS pop-up selection box has options for selecting or creating a new program, sending the output to the current program, or canceling out of the IPS recorder and going back to the Toolpath tab. I'm going to create a new program, so I type 0, 200, press the right enter key, and my program is created. Now I press the right enter key again to paste the G code into the program, and press the right enter key one more time to return to the IPS tab. I press edit to return to my DXF file. To continue my programming process, I'll scroll to my next set of geometry and press F2 to chain. Now notice, my second group is listed here under the Current Groups section. I'll press F3 to select my next cutting operation. In this case, I'll contour the outside shape of my part. I'm going to fill in the cut data and press F4 to insert this operation into my program. This time, I'm going to select option number 2, Output to Current Program. I scroll to the position where I want to insert the code and press the right key. It inserts the code into my program. I hit right one more time to get back to my intuitive programming operation and press edit to get back to DXF import. I continue building my program one operation at a time. It truly is that easy to import geometry into the Haas control and apply cutting operations to it.